Welcome to this Made for Success audio program. The audio you are listening to is designed to turn your potential into performance, succeed in every area of your life, and achieve your dreams. Now sit back and relax as our featured speaker begins.
Hey, this is Kendal Netmaker, live from the studio, and today we are going to be talking about the entrepreneur within. Today we're going to focus on getting into the mindset of why an entrepreneur succeeds, especially the super successful ones that you see online, on Facebook, on Instagram, on LinkedIn, and so on. What sets them apart from everybody else, and how can we use what they know and apply it to our lives so that we can also see exceptional results coming from ourselves? To demonstrate this, I'm going to be sharing with you some personal examples of what we've done in our business and also some of our clients, some of our coaching clients and so on. And we're going to combine a lot of the most successful outcomes and how you can apply them in your business, your organization, your personal life and so on. And I really want to emphasize something. There is something that really allows entrepreneurs to succeed. You see, if you were to put yourself in an organization, and let's pretend you have some team members, you have staff members and so on, and they also have managers, they have VPs, they have C-level executives and so on, and that ladder just keeps going higher and higher and higher. The difference between an entrepreneur and someone who works in that field is that an entrepreneur is able to make decisions on the spot, on the go. In reality, they are actually able to execute much faster than most people on their ideas. They're able to try more experiments. They're able to risk failure more often than most people. They're able to focus more because they have less noise around them. They're able to focus on the ideas that are in the back of their mind so that they can push forward and execute more and more ideas. And the more outcomes that they produce, the more they're able to find what works for them, and they focus and execute on what works for them nonstop every single day. I believe there's three key distinctive factors that separate an entrepreneur than most people out there in the workplace. Number one is mindset. Entrepreneurs, they just think differently. They have a different mindset in how they approach problems, how they approach conflict. They actually embrace obstacles differently than other people out there. Number two, they focus on what they're good at, their skill set. They focus on their core strengths and they apply them to their businesses. They apply them to their organization, and they're able to delegate what they're not so good at. And number three is they're able to execute much faster with speed, with grit than most other people out there. Those three things, I believe, are the three most important factors of why entrepreneurs think and win differently than most people. The very first business I ever started and that really taught me the most lessons out of everything that I've started and produced since that time, it was way back in 2010. In 2010, I was a full-time student at the University of Saskatchewan in Saskatoon. And I used to think, with my current mindset at that time, I thought that I was going to become a phys ed teacher. I was going to become a teacher teaching sports and so on, all that kind of stuff, because I was an athlete back then. And so my mindset was so fixed on becoming a teacher and focusing on that. When I got into business, it was kind of by accident. I had seen a poster of a business planning competition, and I thought that I had a pretty cool idea to try and apply to this. But there was a few things that I didn't realize that were to my disadvantage. One, I had no idea how to write a business plan. Two, I had no idea what a business pitch was. And just to add to that, I was an education student. So automatically, people assumed that I was not in business or I could never start a business because of my background. So going into these business competitions, I was forced to just throw myself out there and learn as much as I possibly could. So I would hear about these competitions and I would go to their free workshops, free seminars, and I would immerse myself into learning about how do I write a business plan. And what I would also do is I would take people out for coffee, people who knew how to write a business plan or had an existing business already. And I would sit there with a notepad and notes, and I would take all these notes at a local.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.